Hello, fellow knees. The video today will be talking about some things to prepare before ROG starts. In case you didn't catch this when watching the preview video, since it's quite content heavy. So if you haven't watched my preview video, I'll also put the link on the top right hand corner. So firstly, I'll advise you to save your AP drinks. The event duration for Gobbler has been shortened into 16 days as compared to 20 days in the CN server. As such, if the AP cost remains at 3k, it means that we had to spend 180 to 200 AP every day in order to finish this event. So I did a short calculation for the free-to-play. The free-to-play will earn 240 from natural regeneration and 60 from completing daily tasks. As such, we have 300 energy daily and hence 2100 weekly. So for this calculation, I focus on finishing daily and weekly tasks for the S-chip as well as the Temple of Trial. Hence, I added in the work permit and anomaly in the weekly table. So as you can see, even if we don't do field work, the AP cost is still not enough for us. Therefore, I did a more extreme case where you can only do one business consult and one operation assessment daily. I personally feel that it's a waste to give up on them since it's already limited to 2 per day, but if you really don't have enough energy, I think that this would be the best choice. The recommendation I have now is to complete your weekly task before the event starts and save any extra energy drinks you have for the next week, and then save any extra you had in the next week for the week after. So when the event begins, you had to give up on your fieldwork and perhaps you can only do 5 work permit and 15 anomaly a week, unless you have extra lah, depending on your situation, you can adjust it. So secondly, train your Luk and Mari's cards. As you can see from my preview video, I mentioned that the power requirement is 45 to 59k and you can only use the respective male leads card. This means that if you do the Luk route, you can only use Luk cards in your main and support deck. And the recommend power I had is for it to reach 60k to be safe. And the same thing goes with doing Mari's deck. As such, I advise you all to start working on these two characters card if your deck haven't reached the required power. And when you are choosing which route to take, also take this into consideration. Like if your Mari's deck is already like 59k and your Luk deck is like 48k, obviously you should go with the Mari's route first because you can complete it and take the time when you are doing the Mari's route to train your Luk's card so you are prepared when you finish Mari's route. Thirdly, invitations. So both invitation is paid this time, but if you're considering to buy one, please control your hand and buy them after you complete the route, because there will be discount given to you after you finish the respective male leads route. And lastly, the banners. So this event should be a normal banner, as such, the card will most likely enter the rotation banner after the event. In fact, the CN server now is having the RRG cards in their rotation. So as a final reminder to the free-to-play, don't draw for this card if this banner is already out of your plan and it will disrupt your plan. So basically, drawing for birthday banners and limited banners are always more worth for the free-to-play given the discount PT and the longer time it takes for them to rerun. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope that it will be helpful for y'all to brace the unexpected RRG event. Thanks for watching and remember to like and subscribe. 加